they're desperate. Okay.
Wait! In the course of human events, it becomes necessary for one people to dissolve the political bands which have connected them with another, and to assume among the powers of the earth separate and equal stations with the laws of nature and the nature's God entitled them. A decent respect to the opinions of mankind requires that they should declare the causes which impel them to the separation. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
That they are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights. Among these are
life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
To secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, deriving their just powers from the consent of the governed.
That whenever any form of government becomes destructive of these ends, it is the right of the people to alter or to abolish it, and to institute new government, laying its foundation on such principles and organizing its power in such form as to then shall be most likely to affect their safety and happiness.
Prudence will dictate that government long established should not be changed for light and transient causes. But when a long train of abuses and usurpations evinces a design to reduce them under absolute despotism, it is their right, it is their duty to throw off such government and to provide new guards for their future security.
We, therefore, the representatives of the United States of America, in General Congress assembled,
appealing to the Supreme Judge of the world for the rectitude of our intentions, do in the name and by the authority of the good people of these colonies solemnly publish and declare
that these united colonies are and of right ought to be free and independent states.
That they are absolved from all allegiance to the British Crown.
That all political connections between them and the state of Great Britain is
and ought to be
totally dissolved. And for the support of this declaration, with a firm reliance on the protection of divine providence, we mutually pledge to each other
our lives, our fortunes, and our sacred honor.
Attached to this document are the names of 56 men.
Collectively, we refer to them as our founding fathers.
We are not them.
We couldn't be. We had a war to fight,
children to raise,
a nation to begin.
Private Joseph von Martin, Continental Army.
All our stories are in the history books if you look hard enough.
For hair, the Philadelphia Light Horse.
And our stories are as much a part of history as that normal decoration.
Mary Clarkson, I survived the yellow fever epidemic.
These are stories of struggle, triumph, great sorrow, and great joy.
David Douglas, player and presenter of plays.
They are not the big stories.
Can we zoom in on them?
Benjamin Franklin, grandson of Benjamin Franklin, printer.
But they are the stories that need to be told because
we are not all Ben Franklin.
We are common people whose uncommon stories came first to a nation.
And no matter what century we were born in,
we all have one thing in common.
We call America home,
and we all help to make history.
Hip hip huzzah!
Thank you.